All right, let's do it.
This is the PrimeWeld TIG325, and it goes out of stock quite often. So while it's back in stock and available, I thought I'd drop this video. I'm going to show several different welds at several different settings, several different thicknesses. So I'm going to start off with just a simple bead-on plate on 1/8 inch thick aluminum. I set the amperage on the machine to 150, and I'm just using a foot pedal. I don't need all 150 amps, but the way aluminum works, sometimes you need a few more amps to start with to get the puddle established, and then you back off a little bit. This is a number 7 Pro Clear Cup, and it is lighting things up. I set the AC balance to 33% cleaning. You can see that there's quite a cleaning zone right here. A little bit more than what's needed, but I still like that the puddle is so clean. Let's magnify that a little bit here. A lot of it's personal preference, but I like to have a little bit of extra cleaning.
This next weld is a corner joint using 1/8 inch thick aluminum. It's a cube, but I'm just going to show one side of that using 115 volt power. Let's do it.
When you're plugged into 115 volt, you're limited on your amperage output, but if you're welding 1/8 inch and under, it's not usually a problem, especially if you're just doing short runs or a small repair on something. For this weld, I'm using a number 6 gas lens, which I think is a really good all-around choice for aluminum, and about 18 to 20 CFH of argon. I'm using 1/16th diameter filler metal and 1/16th diameter tungsten. I'm probably pushing the limits just a little bit for a 1/16th tungsten, but 2% lanthanated does a good job on carrying a lot of current for a given tungsten diameter. One of the reasons why I like it. For some reason, I just decided to experiment with 300 Hertz here. It's kind of annoying to listen to, but it's doing a really good job, and actually it's kind of, seemingly anyway, pushing my travel speed to be a little bit faster. I don't know how long I could weld on 115 volt at this amperage without popping a breaker, but it wasn't a problem with these short runs. And speaking of travel speed, when you're learning to TIG weld, I think 1/8 of an inch per second is a pretty good target to aim for. What I mean by that is moving the torch along 1/8 of an inch in between dabs of filler metal and dabbing filler metal about every 1 second. And that'll give you a travel speed of 1 inch for every 8 seconds, which figures out to be roughly between 5 and 6 inches a minute. Now that's fairly slow, but your speed will pick up as you get better.
This next weld is a much thinner aluminum. It's 050 thickness, still a corner joint. For thinner metal, sometimes I use a slightly different technique.
For thin aluminum corner joints, I think there's some benefit to going kind of high on the AC frequency. So I set it to 200 Hertz. I set the AC balance to 33% cleaning. I'm using a tapered tip electrode with a clear Ali 5 cup. Going back to travel speed, I've got scribe marks every 1 inch now, and you could count off just about 8 seconds for every 1 inch. On a thin outside corner joint, you can only step out so far before you risk keyholing or blowing out. Most of the time, you don't have any problems getting full penetration on something this thin. And how much penetration you want just depends on the application. You can kind of see this puddle sink in between dabs here. That's a good sign you're getting full penetration.
All right, coming up is kind of like a socket weld that I did on a turntable. It's 1/2 inch thickness to 1/4 inch thickness. This is where a preheat would help or a helium mix would help. I welded it with straight argon and I tested it afterwards.
I found this piece tack welded in a bucket, and it was in my shop for months and months before I decided to make a video out of it. It's not all that clean. In fact, you can see a pore on that tack weld, but I'm going to weld it anyway just for the sake of the video. This is how I prep tungsten a lot of times for thicker aluminum, just with a blunt taper, and then I just let it round a little bit on the tip. Now, I used a little bit more cleaning action on this than I usually would, again, because it wasn't all that clean. But it looks like 35% cleaning is going to be just about enough here. Thick aluminum like this would weld a lot better with some kind of a preheat. I didn't preheat it other than just to test out that cleaning action a little bit. I'm going to use 175 Hertz, just experimenting. If I was limited on amperage, I would use a lower frequency to get a little bit more heat into the part, but I've got plenty of amperage here. I just wanted to see if 175 hertz would get a little bit better penetration into the root of that joint. I was up around 210 to 220 amps for this weld. With a 325 amp machine, I had plenty of more amperage to go, but much more amperage I would just risk chewing off that ledge, and it didn't seem to want to go into the root any better. So while it looked okay, I decided to test it using the cut and etch method. It didn't look like it was really getting into that root, but it did better than I thought.
This next weld was the very first weld on aluminum that I did with this machine. It's 1/4 inch thick, outside corner joint. I used a water-cooled setup. Well, you'll see.
With this machine, I have plenty of amperage to use pretty much any AC frequency I want, but I just decided to drop it down all the way to 50 hertz. I set the AC balance on 35% cleaning, and I went maximum amperage on the main amperage. I didn't quite need it all. I used a 1/8 2% lanthanated tungsten with a number 6 gas lens setup. Using the foot pedal, along with a fairly tight arc, I used just enough amperage to where the toes of that weld, the toes are the edges of the weld, just barely consumed the corners. So the actual readout on the amperage wound up being somewhere between 230 and 250 amps for this weld. In this shot, you can kind of see that cleaning action ahead of the puddle and a nice clean mirror-like puddle, which is kind of what you want to see. As I mentioned, this machine goes out of stock quite often, but it is available now. You can learn more at weldmonger.com. You can either order the machine by itself, but we've got it bundled with a water cooler and a water-cooled TIG torch and a bunch of other good accessories for a good savings.